Yo. Yeah, are we on air? Yeah, that's what time it is. WolfTix Radio, you know what I mean? Check it out. Tonight, discussion 2012, the only hip hop discussion about 2012, you know what I mean? You know, people think, you know, it's gonna be the end of the world, all kind of calamities, space aliens supposed to come back, or whatever it is, but, you know, we pretty much gonna have a discussion about it, you know what I mean? I'm waiting on Scholar, you know what I'm saying? Name in itself says it all. My dude Pure, Pure Etc., and homie Six Beats, supposed to join me live. Just going and check it out, you know what I mean? Gonna get into this, little slumville. You know what time it is. Yeah. Yeah. Y'all know what time it is. WolfTix Radio up in this piece. And check this out. You can tweet me. Go ahead and tweet at WolfTickets. That's WOLFTIX. Or just go ahead and hit me at AO2K. It's WolfTix Radio, you know what I mean? Let's get into this whole, you know, situations that's going on right now in the world right now with hip hop. Check the blurbs, check the blogs and all that. Ooh. You know what I'm saying? Just, you know, nonsense. Who we got here? It says, alright. Apparently, Will Smith, according to media takeout, what he doing, man? He going to dinner with a blonde chick? Guess him and Jada are pretty much over or something, you know what I mean? I don't know. Got a whole little Mark Anthony thing that happened a few months ago. That was all in relation to get ratings for her show that got canceled, you know what I'm saying? So supposedly, you know what I'm saying? That's pretty much what that was about. But, let me see. Who else they saying? Beyonce out shopping. Huge pregnant is Monique. Okay, that's a little disrespectful. No disrespect to Monique. But, you know what I'm saying? I'm just saying them. Media takeout. Just being real disrespectful. You know what I mean? We got here, pretty much nonsense, bunch of shenanigans going on though. Check it out. Let me see what else we got here. Okay, Fabulous. Okay, what is it? He got Emily B reportedly pregnant by him. Who is Emily B first off? You know what I mean? Go ahead and click into this and see what they're talking about. Yo, yeah, I think she's one of those NFL basketball wives or whatever. See, that's what I'm saying. I had enough about that. I had enough. Come on now. Basketball wife. All right, here she is. Okay. You said she was wondering who child father was. And they saying it's Fabulous. They've been on and off for pretty much about 10 years. But she's also been seen with Mike Vick and Darrell Revis. So, I don't know, man. That's going to sound like a Maury Show episode right there, you know what I mean? We're going to go ahead and get into something else, man. Who we got here now is Ghostface Killer off the Pretty Tony album. It's over.
Yo, it's over. Hey, yo, this joint right here is about when you going through mad shit.
What?
That's why I let you slide, nigga.
Word.
Get you a 42 and pass it by, man.
Yeah. Yeah. 788 DDT a nigga, just like Jake the Snake. Actually, we don't participate, but if you do, then I'ma see you as your wag user. Don't let the drama fluctuate. I don't wanna. Got it. Could be safe. We'll be at if you let you do that. We probably be playing on a bag. You're talking this and that. You wanna, you know what it is?
It's WolfTix Radio.
Yeah, what time it is right now? I'm still sitting here waiting for my special guest, Pure Etc. Where you at, son? cat trying to come, you know what I'm saying? Get this discussion. 2012. Go ahead and tweet at Wolf Tickets. That's at WOLFTIX. Twitter, you know what I mean? Y'all know about Twitter.com. Pretty sure you know. And also, I'm on Facebook. It's Facebook.com/holler at these. For real, holler at these. You know what I'm saying? That's the Facebook. I'm going to go ahead and get into this other little joint right here. Who's this, my man here? Most Def. Spitting that real, you know what I'm talking about? Hey, y'all got to listen to this, though. The topic of this right here, so that's the real something that will be affected the next couple.
That cool, refreshing drink.
You know?
Try it with your friend.
Yasin, what up, boy?
Tide rise high. Come inland and make your house go by. Fools done upset the old man river. Made him carry slave ships and fed him dead niggas. Now his belly full and he about to flood something. So I'm throwing rope that ain't tied to nothing. Tell your crew use the H2 and Y's amounts. It's the new world water and every drop counts. You can laugh and take it as a joke if you wanna, but it don't rain a full week some summers. And it's about to get real wild in the half. You be buying every yard just to take a fucking bath. Hedges acting wild, sipping brew and pumping dank. Competing with the next man for higher playing rank. So now I ain't got time trying to be Big Hank. Fuck a bank. I need a 20-year water tank. Cause while these knuckleheads is out here sweating their guts, sun is sitting in the treetops, burning the woods. And as the flame from the blaze get higher and higher, they say, don't drink the water, we need it for the fire. New York is drinking it. New world. All of California is drinking it. New world. Way up north and down south is drinking it. New world. Used to have minerals and zinc in it. New world. Now they say it got lead and stink in it. New world. Fluorocarbons and monoxide. Push the water table lopsided. Used to be free, now of course you will feed. Cause all tanks fully loaded, they roll across the sea. Man, you gotta cook with it, baby, clean with it.
That's right.
When it's hot summertime, you fiend for it.
No.
You gotta put it in the iron you steaming
that's
with.
Right.
It's what they dress wounds and treat diseases
shout
with.
It out.
The rich and poor, black and white got need for
that's it. Right.
And everybody in the world can agree with
that.
Consumption promotes health and easiness.
That's
go
right.
Too long without it on this earth and you leaving
shout it. Out.
Americans wasting it on some leisure shit.
Right.
Another nation be desperately seeking
that
it.
Enough.
Bacteria washing up on their beaches.
Say
and
word.
Don't drink the water so they can't wash their feet with
that
it.
Enough.
Young babies in perpetual neediness. Epidemics hopping up off the petri
that
dish.
Enough.
Control centers try to play all secret
that
at
word.
To avoid public panic and freaking.
That
there
enough.
Are places where TB is common as TV. Cause foreign based companies go and get greedy. The type of cats who pollute the whole shoreline have it purified and sell it for $1.25. Now the world is drinking
word.
That.
New
your mom's
water.
Wife and baby girl is drinking
word.
That.
New world.
Up north and down south is drinking
word.
It.
New world.
You just
water.
Have to go to your sink for it.
New
the
world.
Cash register is going to chink for
world.
It.
New world.
Pearl carbons and monoxide. Got the fish looking cockeyed. Used to be free. Now, of course, you will feed. Cause it's all about getting that cash.
Money.
Said 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 it's all about getting your cash.
Money.
Said it's all about getting that cash.
Money.
Said it's all about getting that cash.
Money.
Said it's all about getting that cash.
Money.
Everything around me, move.
Yeah. Yo, some more situations. Check it out. Got some word that I think my man Floyd Mayweather, he gotta do 90 days in jail. Let me see. Let me check up more about this situation with Floyd Mayweather. He said he got to do 90 days. I mean, shoot. If he do it at L.A. County, man, he'd be out, shoot. What's that, like 6 hours? Good talk. Let me see. But yeah, it says Floyd Mayweather, according to allhiphop.com, 90 days in jail. Today, he'll be serving his 90-day jail sentence following the guilty sentence from a domestic violence incident back in 2010. Says he is expected to turn himself in on the 6th. And, according to the charges, September 2010, the incident involved his child in front of him. And then he later threatened to beat him as well. Beat them or beat the kids, I don't know. So he later reached a plea deal, which he was played guilty to a misdemeanor. No contact. Harassment charges. And two harassment charges, whatever. So, says he was sentenced to 6 months in jail, but three of that sentence was suspended, and he was 3 days of good credit, time of serve. So part of the plea deal, he was served 6 months in jail, but the three has been suspended, so it was like 100 community hours service and paid $2,000 fine. So along with a year-long program for domestic violence. So, guess he'll be doing 90 days. I guess that's in Florida. Is that Florida? I don't know. Like I said, if he was L.A. County, homie, bro, you already know what time it is, man. He be in that mug so in, so out. That's how Lee Baca does it, you know what I mean? You be in there like 3 days, 90 days. All right, we're going to get into some rumors, man. I see, Kendrick Lamar, T.I., and R. Kelly, Mac Miller. What do they all have in common? Well, they all in the rumor section. That's what it is right now. It says T.I. drops a new trailer for his New Year's Eve mixtape, F the City Up. You know what I mean? So you can check that out. Where we at? This is on allhiphop.com. Pretty much dropping a mixtape. First of the year. It's good to see T.I. I know he's been putting in work, you know what I'm saying? So that's pretty much what it is. We got it. Another incident here. Let me see. The Throne has officially performed Niggas in Paris for 613 minutes, 20 seconds last year. Wow, they actually counted that. You know what I'm talking about? It's another quickie. Nicki Minaj, she will be performing Super Bowl in February along with Madonna. I guess they'll be doing that song, Super Bass. You got that boom, 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 whatever that is, you know what I mean? Funny thing is, I just heard her do this new diss song to Lil' Kim. She needs to leave that alone. I mean, you know what I'm saying? You won the battle. Now you just, you know what I'm saying? I think that's kind of mean. You just kind of throw a little salt in the wound. You got a song out there called Stupid Ho. Y'all check it out. It's kind of funny. It's like, really? I mean, you want it like that? Yeah, she's calling Lil' Kim a stupid ho. Nonetheless, HBO canceled Hung and How to Make It in America. That's that song. I mean, that's that show with my man. My man named got that song, you know what I mean? Y'all know who I'm talking about, but they canceled some shows though. Whole situation and Bored to Death. I mean, the title says it all. Bored to Death. Hey, you know what I mean? Anyway, let me get on into some more of this here. Who we got coming up? Yeah, it's my dude Razzy. Razzcast. New little EP he got for the people right now, man. Jack Frost Part 2. This is off the EP Yellow Snow. It's free. Go download it. Go check them out. Bandcamp.com. Razzcast.bandcamp.com. I think this is hot. It's all a little knowledge in here, too. Y'all need to pay attention real close. You know what I'm saying?
It's Wolf Tickets Radio.
Baby, let me do all the work.
Wait, let me put this record on.
Yeah.
I like that.
I like that too, baby. Well, check this out.
Wait, let me put this record on.
Put the record on. Yeah. Live in full effect. Wolf Tickets. Wolf Tickets Radio, you know what I mean? Yo. I really didn't introduce myself. I go by Wolfgang Amadeuz. And I speak aggressively on topics in relation to hip-hop, politics, in any topic. You know what I'm saying? I'm not just kind of going to just talk about hip-hop. Not just going to talk about politics, religion. You know, if you got any ideas, you can go ahead and you hit me, you tweet me. at AO2K. Or you go ahead and you could tweet Wolf Tickets at Wolf Ticks, WOLFTIX. You know what I'm saying? That's pretty much what it is, though. So, yeah. What else we got? What else is going on in this world? You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, you turn on the news, you see a bunch of bush. You know what I'm saying? Just a bunch of bull ish. You know what I mean? So, we got to get back to the real. Don't be programmed into accepting what they spew out. The media, that is. You know what I'm saying? And you know, get down to the root of things. Okay. So, here we go. Yeah, by the way, this is my dude, One Man. Wolfgang Yellow Jackets, this is some production he did way back in the day. Boy, don't know, I went and dug in the crates, dug in the tapes. I don't even think a lot of cats even deal with tapes. But I went ahead and converted the tapes to CD, digitized them. Man, because it was some fire. Yo, cats had fire back in the day, man. Real raw hip hop before the Fruity Loops. Nothing against Fruity Loops. Not against none of these new little whatevers. For the most part, man, just raw hop. That's what it was. You know what I'm saying? That's what you're listening to right now. So here it is right now. Let me see. Like I said, go ahead, tweet your boy right here, AO2K. You tweet me, and you know, you gotta request. I'll go ahead and play it. I'll go ahead and do what I need to do to, you know, get it on. Get it on. Okay. Alright, so let me do this. Since I was talking about dope, let me get into some killer dope. Yeah.
Who dispose all penalty? You know that's one man on me.
One man.
The world is living so far.
It's one of them joints, y'all.
The world is wrong.
Some old throwback classic Outworld. That's what it is. Sam?
You know that's one man on me.
It's like some old interlude shit. Sound like Three's Company. Alright, so yeah.
It's Wolf Tickets Radio.
That's what time it is, y'all. Here it is. 2 weeks. Well, actually, a year from now. It's supposed to be the end of the world. Did y'all know that? End of the world, man. It's supposed to be 2012. You know what I'm saying? It's all kind of myths going on. It's like the song that's played by Raz. Scenario 2012. He said, what you gonna do in 2012? Even though the Mayans said we're going to burn in hell. You know what I'm talking about? It's kind of like, it's a whole lot of myth, a whole lot of just, you know, it's kind of like, it kind of reminded me of 12 years ago with 2000 when it first came with, you know, Y2K, a whole bunch of hysteria. You know, planet's supposed to hit the earth, some aliens supposed to come back, and, you know, I don't know. But for the most part, I got my mans here, Pure's on his way. Pure be here. Pure etc. That's at Pure etc. on Twitter. Got my dude Scholar right here.
Mic check. What's good?
Yeah. Okay. So yeah, for the most part though, Scholar, my dude Six Beats. Go ahead and say what's up.
What up?
Yeah, no, y'all get, grab the mic, y'all MCs, y'all know what time it is. It's hip hop. I just threw that down there. That's kind of like a courtesy thing.
Yeah, my bad. I didn't want to, you know, start, you know, taking your shine away or talking while you're talking. But
nah, it's all good.
So y'all, Scholar is here.
Yeah.
Before I say anything about 2012, let me preface by saying I am by no means an expert. My name is Scholar because I'm just that, and I I consider myself somewhat of a, I guess, a Renaissance man with poor memory. So I've corroborated as much information as I could, and offer my own analysis on what's going to happen. But hey, trust, I don't got no secret scrolls, or I haven't studied this. You know, I got other things going on as well. You know. I'm an MC. You can visit my website, scholarshere.com.
Right.
Depending on when you hear this, there may be, you know, not much there, but I'm dropping my album 2012. Stay tuned. I'll be back. Y'all know more about it when it's getting closer.
Yeah.
Six Beats, holla at him.
Yo, what up? What up? Shit, you know, I'm just Six Beats, man, you know. Just doing my thing over here. I'm not quite the scholar that a scholar is over here, but...
Don't be modest.
You know, I do my thing. I'm just, you know, I'm just on one. That's all.
Yeah, okay. Well, we're going to get into the situation at hand. So,
okay.
Go ahead, Scholar. Check this out, man. I got a question. Yeah, you say you're not versed in it, but you've heard things about 2012.
You got to.
So
can't ignore it.
What have you heard about 2012?
Okay, so the big hoopla about 2012, basically, is that is the end of the Mayan long calendar.
Yeah.
And the Mayans are a civilization in South America that were known to have a lot of knowledge in astronomy, the stars, and their calendar was, in fact, very accurate. Now, on December 21st, 2012, it is the winter solstice.
Yeah.
And according to the Mayans, it's the return of Quetzalcoatl, which is a god.
Mm-hmm.
It's the end of an era and the beginning of a new era.
Right.
So many people take this as the end of the world. And of course, the Chinese I Ching calendar also mentioned that's when their calendar ended.
Yeah.
I believe there's other civilizations out there. I think I heard that Merlin, over in Europe. Merlin apparently wasn't just a person. Merlin was a tribe of something akin to witch doctors.
Right.
And they had a similar prophetic statement about December 21st, 2012. So
yeah.
There's a variety of reasons why people have come up with this date as the end of the world, quote unquote.
Okay. No doubt. All right. Six. What's your take on it, man? What have you heard about 2012? December 21st, 2012.
Man, it's quite a few things that... That I've seen books about, and that I've heard about from, you know, different people talking to all the people that I talk to about this subject. I mean, it could go with this scientific. There's psychological. I mean, which way do you want me to go first? You know?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people are saying that 2012 can mean a lot of different things. You know, there's a lot of possibilities out there. Of course, we can only just conjecture at the moment, but in many ways.
So, scientifically, let's go there, because, I mean, you know, 2012, what was it, October, okay, according to the Mayan calendar, they're on a 13-month calendar, or a cycle. The end of the cycle actually happened sometime in, sometime in October, I believe. So, the end of the next cycle... Of the long, it's like you said, it's a long count calendar. The end of the calendar will be December 21st, 2012. That's from what I've read, from what I've been told, from you know the History Channel. That BS on the History Channel. They can do them little things on there. So that's
very well done documentary, but, or you know channel.
Yeah. But I mean, you know, I would suggest to read. That's pretty much where I'm coming at it. Tell everyone to read and just kind of, you know, go from there. But scientifically,
mm-hmm.
What have you heard about that date, the December 21st, 2012?
Okay, well, scientifically, let me break it down for you.
Go ahead.
It's like this.
Yeah.
Okay, now, basically, the Earth is running on, has two poles, two magnetic poles. Everyone should know this. It's, you know,
North and South.
Grade school science, you know what I'm saying? You got a North Pole, you got the South Pole. Okay?
Right.
Now, what scientists have taken from doing a lot of studies on geological science, basically geological studies on the Earth.
Yeah.
A lot of the solar radiation that's coming from the sun is affecting the way the shift of the balance of the poles of the Earth.
Right.
And there have been actually our ozone layer is getting so bad right now that the solar radiation that hit us. Maybe some 50 years ago, something like that, 100 years ago, that hit us, it affected, the planet got really hot and went through like a small climate change.
Okay.
Right?
Right.
But now that our ozone layer is so depleted by now, like, it's, I think it's been reduced by like, I don't know, like half since like 2000.
Okay.
It's real bad.
Okay.
Okay, so basically they're predicting this solar flare in the sun to kind of come out and fly at the Earth faster and harder than it's ever done before.
Right.
In history.
Okay.
Now, normally if our ozone was okay and if our, you know, our environment was in a better state, normally we'd be able to withstand this type of radiation and it would have been absorbed in the ozone layer and, you know, would have taken it in.
No doubt.
But since it's so bad, it's going to go right through it. It's going to affect, it's going to hit the Earth, and you're going to feel a giant heat wave, and it's going to cause a lot of climate change, just geological changes, and it's going to cause the poles, north and south,
mm-hmm.
to shift.
Okay.
All the way from up and down to left to right.
East-west.
Yeah, it's going to be east-west now.
So, and this is predicted for that date. This isn't that...
Well,
this,
yeah, that day is when the flare will hit and it will begin there.
Okay.
Yeah, it will begin on that day.
Okay, but, I mean, you know, scientifically, I'm not a scientist, but we do get solar flares. I mean, you know, the sun has a cycle as well.
The solar flares and everything is common.
Yeah.
It's common. It happens every day and you don't even know it.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But this one is going to be like, it's just going to be something's going to go on in the sun where... I don't know if there's an energy flux or something like that, but it's going to send it out. It's going to be a large amount of radiation is coming out.
No doubt.
Is this solar flare conjecture, or is this widely scientifically agreed upon? Where they're saying this could happen on this day.
They're saying this is what they're anticipating.
Who is they?
I guess this from this book I read. I guess the scientists,
conjecture. It's pretty much conjecture at the point.
Yeah, well, okay. Yeah. I mean, all of it is.
Yeah, right.
You know.
Yeah, it's nothing solid. I don't think
all of it is really. But
okay.
But this is. But you know, to them that whatever they've come up with, these physicists and these astrologists, things like that, astrophysicists, whatever. Like they, that's what they're anticipating is for this solar flare to happen.
Uh-huh. Okay.
You know.
Okay.
I have a different scientific information.
What do you have?
It's in relation to the black hole at the center of our galaxy.
Okay.
So what we can confirm is that there's a black hole at the center of pretty much every galaxy, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And this is kind of like the mass that holds everything together.
Right.
Now, on December 21st, 2012, what is called the winter solstice, the sun, the earth, and this black hole are supposed to line up.
Right.
Okay? Now, in my opinion, this doesn't seem too significant to me because every planet, their sun, and this black hole will have to line up at some point.
Mm-hmm.
And so what, does every single one go through some dramatic, pole shift? I highly doubt that. I don't think that's what happens. However, this relates kind of scientifically in a little bit back to what the Mayans say about 2012, which is they refer to the Milky Way as the sacred tree. Okay?
Okay.
And apparently on December 21st, 2012, is the day that they pass this sacred tree. It's the sun crossing from one side to another.
Okay.
Signifying the beginning of a new age.
Yeah.
Now, what some are also conjecturing is that on a day... I don't know if this is 100% confirmed, but there will be a pole shift. There will be a pole shift on December 21st, 2012.
Mm-hmm.
The pole shifts happen... I think every something like 300,000 years. I'm sorry, I don't know everything verbatim.
Yeah, right. But yeah,
I think according to NASA, the planet's magnetic field reverses every 200,000 to 300,000 years.
And is it did they say it's like a gradual shift?
It's
or
a gradual
is it, it's
shift.
Gradual.
Okay.
Okay,
it's a gradual shift.
So it's going to start, or
it starts. Yes. In fact, the changes is usually occurs over hundreds of thousands of years.
Right.
The last reversal happened 780,000 years ago, if I remember correctly.
Okay.
And this is according to NASA. And but we're overdue. We're overdue for another one. However, the last time there was a pole shift, there was no significant change in the disruption in the amount of life on Earth.
Right.
As far as I remember correctly, there's been four extinction and level events that happened on Earth.
Yeah.
The most famous, of course, the one that wiped out the dinosaurs.
Yeah.
And this had nothing to do with pole shifts.
Okay.
So. Will there be a pole shift? Yes, according to NASA, there will be. But does that mean it's the end of the world? No.
Right.
But and some think it just may be more drastic on this day.
Gotcha. And we have the, you know, we'll come in, we'll go into the song,
right,
and then we'll come back and further elaborate on the whole, like you said, 65 million years ago when asteroid hit the planet and supposedly wiped out the dinosaurs. I guess other suggest that 2012 is supposed to be another catastrophe, the arrival of the next solar maximum, like you were saying, the sun goes from one side of the galaxy to the other or something like that, and Earth's collision with the a passing asteroid or a supposed planet called Nibiru.
Nibiru.
Yeah.
Garbage, in my opinion.
We'll talk about that though.
When we see that planet in the sky.
You know, when we get into it, you know what I'm saying. We'll talk about it next time. Kind of after the song here, we'll get into it with Nibiru. Kind of more or less just myth. You know. Let's get into that. We'll definitely talk more about the long count calendar.
Now you may want to write this down,
and let's get into a little bit of Mayan history. Just, you know, a little brief thing in Mayan history.
And those who
all right, we'll be back, y'all.
You say I'm just not down with it. Well, they're right. I'm not a trendy dude. You average Joes probably won't figure this out till after I'm gone. You'll realize then that the man named was the real deal. Now you know the man who's gonna take you down. So do me a favor and die with style.
Transmitting live via satellite.
It's Wolf Tickets Radio.
Yeah. Alright. Yes, alright. We back on?
Yeah, we on.
Let's go.
What up?
Yeah. I got Scholar.
Yes, sir.
ScholarIsHere.com. Let me turn myself down, son. Son, I'm over here blowing speakers the hell away. Yeah. ScholarIsHere.com. The revolution is here.
Right now.
Yeah.
And we got 1 year left if y'all paying attention.
There's only 1 year left.
Exactly.
Yo. And I got six beats.
Yeah, what up, what up, what up?
Yeah. So basically, man, we was on the whole phenomena 2012. The first and only discussion in hip hop we're gonna go through with this little thing we got here with 2012. Since 2012 is like about a week and a half away, and supposedly it's supposed to be the end of the year. End of the world. My bad. End of the year.
Yeah, well, it'll be the end of the year for sure, man.
Yeah. It'll definitely be the end of the year.
I can confirm that, actually.
Yeah.
I've got sources.
Ryan Seacrest said he'll be end of the year. The ball drop, no doubt.
So, yeah.
That is. Okay. Now, here we go with this. Like I said, we were going to talk about long count calendar.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to do a little brief history about the Mayan civilization. Mayan civilization, it's pretty much the only, no, I can't say the only, but they were the only civilization in North America to create the pyramid, step pyramid. Is that correct?
Right. I believe the Aztecs also had pyramids.
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
Interesting.
They're just, structurally, they're just slightly different.
Okay,
yeah.
Gotcha. All right. So
in Ecuador, there's also pyramids too, aren't
yeah,
there?
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, in Ecuador.
Okay.
In Peru.
No, Peru doesn't have any pyramids.
Is that in Peru?
I don't think so.
Nope.
I don't know. We need a fact person here, but
yeah, we do.
But I think there's no pyramids in Peru. I'm pretty sure.
All right. Well, yeah. Well, here it is. Mayan calendar, the Mayan civilization. Mayans were Central America, Southern Mexico, that's pretty much where they were. So they were close to the equator, if you would, you know, kind of figure out where they were on this planet. And the civilization thrived for how many years? A couple thousand years. They were actually predate what we were talking, like close to, they say some carbon dated around 2600 BC. That's when they actually they probably were here before that, but this was in Belize. So I guess that's all in relation to where the Mayans were. Like I said, Central America, Southern Mexico. So basically, what I'm just basically trying to get at is they were an advanced civilization.
Yeah, well, What we confirm is that they definitely knew a lot about stars.
Right.
You know, before big cities and lights and electricity and all that stuff, the stars were a big deal.
Yeah.
Basically, every single civilization. That's why you have, you know, so many cultures throughout history that have an extensive knowledge of the stars. Because imagine living during that time period, and at, you know, whenever it's dark, you just see us, you know, just so many lights in the sky.
Right.
So
yeah.
The Mayans definitely knew about stars.
Right. So they tracked. They pretty much tracked stars, and for thousands of years, they developed the Mayan calendar. Because the stars would move in such a fashion to where they could track them, essentially, basically figure out their where they're at in the universe, and that's pretty much how they got the long count. What the long count is 5,125 years. I think actually that is the long count. It's every 5,125 years. So we're at the end of astronomical calendar.
Right.
So next is the reason why I brought that up is just to say, okay, they were not what would you say, savages. People would automatically assume.
Of course not.
You know, but they actually were onto some shit. They
exactly,
were on,
ancient civilizations, you know, we think, oh, they didn't have cars and they didn't have planes, so they must have been dumb. If anyone has that perception, that of course is very ignorant. Many of these past civilizations were extremely advanced, had wonderful technology, and they understood things. You know, if you look at the geolithic structures, they clearly knew things about the world that we don't know today.
Right.
Also, I want to make a clarification. We actually checked it, and there were pyramids in Peru.
Okay.
Yeah, they were.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
You're right. They were. That was the other.
A lot of crazy stuff in Peru, guys. If any scholars are out there, look up that place.
Yeah, Peru's got it all.
Yeah, Peru. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Peru. Yeah, yeah. If there were some scholars, unfortunately, I can't accept any calls right now. But if you want to leave a message, it's not a problem. You go ahead and either hit me at 424-262-WOLF. That's 424-262-9653.
And you can text me if you know my number.
Yeah, or go ahead and tweet him. I think he's at Scholar is here.
Yeah.
Oh, you're not really on
Twitter.
Thanks
for the shout
like
out,
that,
but I'm not using it yet.
Oh man,
I'm resisting Twitter because if it's such an abomination of grammar.
Well, well, you know, you only got 140 something characters to get it in, so that's pretty much what it is, though.
Yeah, it's a system that
But you can tweet me if you don't want to. If you can't find him, you can find me.
Yeah.
At AO2K. That's pretty much where I'm at. I have to wait. So, yeah, no doubt. So basically, here it is right now. Pure. I think he's out there, but you know we're gonna go ahead and hang tight because we have already.
Yeah, I got some interesting.
I got some other questions.
I got some interesting 2012 facts I just want to throw out here. That you may find interesting.
Yeah.
Albert Einstein, one of my favorite people in history, I'm sure many of you, he said that if honeybees were suddenly gone from mankind, if you know something happened to the honeybees, it'd be a sign of the things to come. And after that, we'd only have 4 years to live. And as many of you know, there has been a beginning, honeybees are beginning to disappear.
Right.
So I'm going to, as we go into the next song, look up more information about this, but we've got visitors now.
Yeah.
So Albert Einstein, you know, even himself made a kind of a I wouldn't say a prediction, but he gave him information that may relate to this whole 2012 prophecy. And also the Vatican. The Vatican, there's a prophecy called the Prophecy of St. Malachi.
Yeah.
And according to sources, the Vatican, you know, they listen to this rumor very strongly. And according to this prophecy, that there will be 112 popes until doomsday. So
wow.
Once we have 112 popes, then there will be doomsday. And right now, Pope Benedict is the 111th pope. So according to this prophecy, there'll be one pope after him, and then it's donezo.
Then it's a done deal.
Yeah.
Wow, let's keep this man on life support, bruh.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I'm looking that up right now. It says, most Saint Malachi, medieval Irish priest. And I'm going to further investigate that. You know what I'm saying? I'm glad you brought that to light, but... That's interesting, because, one more, and that's pretty much it. All right, yo, My man.
Yes, sir.
Yo, check this out. So, actually, hold tight. I got something for you. I'm going to go ahead and get into this real quick. Be right back. Y'all know what time it is. WolfTix Radio. Going and, you know, hit you with this Tupac right here. Broken Wings. We're going to get it in.
Tupac, rest in peace.
To the end of time. Yo, I didn't pick these songs on purpose. Like, really. You know what I'm saying? I'm tripping. It's like Tupac, Broken Wings. I'm like, okay, that's a cool
song. I prefer Tupac before death.
Yeah, right. But you know, Tupac, Broken Wings, to the end of time.
Yes.
And that's what the hell we're talking about, the end of time.
On a random playlist.
Yeah. It's in the stars, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, yo. Six.
Yes, sir.
Let's get back into the whole solar flare situation.
Okay.
With what you were explaining scientifically about the sun in relation to 2012.
Right.
Go ahead and speak on that whole situation where you say the sun will rotate the magnetic axis.
Right, the radiation emitted by the sun during that flare is what's going to rotate the axis of the Earth.
Right.
Completely, like, you know, I want to say 90 degrees.
Okay.
You know? So from north to south to east and west. And basically what's going to happen at that time is the Earth is going to go through a whole nother rebirth again. It's basically like how the Earth was created. And according to the Mayans, they believe in that this whole thing is, life is cyclical. And we're reaching the end of the cycle. There's going to be destruction, death, but everything is going to be reborn into something else.
Okay.
Now, with the Earth changing that on such a scale, I mean, it makes sense in that fashion. But what's going down is California is going up to the North Pole. I mean,
sweet.
It's gonna be massive
vacation time.
Yeah, it ain't. Yeah, it ain't Earth as we know it anymore. But really, for the most part, the Earth is gonna be changed. It's gonna be every single natural disaster you could possibly think of. I mean, there's gonna be, you know, all the dust in the air, the climate is just gonna be really bad. You know. You're not going to get a lot of sun coming in. It's going to be darkness. As far as land masses go, South Africa is going to be the most unchanged out of everything.
Okay.
And it's here in South Africa in this region called the Drakensberg Mountains that life or civilization, I guess, has a possibility to continue in this region. Mainly because of its geological location right now. It'll shift, but when everything shifts up, it's going to be turned in to where it's just going to be like kind of at the equator now.
Right.
And for the most part, it'll be unchanged. I'm not really sure. Just, you know, from all the things that are going to be going on, I'm not really sure how big of the chance people have to survive. Considering that, you know, there's going to be tornadoes and earthquakes and volcanoes. I mean,
dinosaurs.
You name it. Yeah, I mean, people think they're gonna crawl about the Earth. You're gonna have Starship Troopers going on. You know what I'm saying? But you know what I'm saying? I don't know how good our chances are surviving. Anyways, if we manage to survive a shift, you know what I mean?
Right.
If the shift happens.
Yeah.
If a big if.
So I mean, I think everything. I mean, you're not gonna be eating any animals. I don't think animals are gonna survive this thing. Whatever, whatever's just in that plateau of land, and there's not too much wildlife that you could survive off of just that one.
In that part of South Africa.
Yeah, and on top of that, I mean, if they're running around, I mean, they're not going to be eating anything. They're probably just going to die from some sort of poisoning or something, you know?
Now, you don't think, hold on. Before we go any further, let me introduce everyone to Pure Etc.
Yo, what up? What's up, universe?
What's up, Pure?
Yeah.
What's going on, man?
Yeah, we over here, you know, like-minded only and, first and only hip-hop discussion about 2012. You know what I'm saying? And when I introduced everyone, I asked them the question, what did you hear? Or, you know, kind of like rumor mill, what did you hear about 2012 when you first started hearing about the whole Mayan or whatever? I don't know, you know, but I'm just asking, what did you initially hear about 2012?
Well, the first things I started hearing about 2012 is the destruction of everything. happening in 2012.
Mm-hmm.
The Earth is going to tilt, and you know that's going to bring certain weather changes. That's going to bring cataclysmic effects, basically.
Okay,
that's what I heard.
That's what you heard.
Yeah.
Now
that's the first time I've ever, you know.
And when did you hear that? When did, like, kind of?
Man, maybe about 10 years ago.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Yeah.
Around 10 years ago.
Way before me.
Yeah, that's about the time I kind of got hit to it too. So you figured if you heard that, and he said about the plateau in South Africa will be the only place inhabitable. Uh-huh. California will be somewhere in the North Pole next to Santa Claus. You know what I mean? Like, don't you think? Would you think that the government would have some type of contingency plan or something like that? Like, I mean, you know,
they already had things set in place for natural disasters,
right?
Such as like underground bunkers and, you know, places where they can stay.
Yeah,
you know, there's a place where the president can stay,
right?
And his staff or whatever,
right?
So, you know, already that stuff's already set in place if anything goes down. So,
oh yeah, of course, and you know, regular people will just get we'll get New Orleans.
Yeah,
you know how New Orleans is in New Orleans. You know what I mean? It's pretty much how it is. So, yeah,
that shit.
Yeah, man, that's yeah. Well, you know, we'll get more into that.
But later. I wanted to ask Six, when is this supposed to happen? Is it supposed to happen like right in on that date?
On the day, yeah.
On the date, that's supposed to happen on that day.
Supposedly they've calculated it to be on that day.
What time?
I don't know the time. I couldn't tell you. And believe me, if I knew, I don't think you'd want to know what time anyway.
No, I would. I'd want to know the time. I get ready for it. You know?
I mean,
real stupid, just, right before it goes down.
It's just crazy because like that's a fucked up day for the Earth,
right?
Yeah.
For us, really,
right?
You know, because how I see it is like really the Earth's not going nowhere, but we are,
right?
Yeah,
no doubt.
Let us know how expendable we are.
Yeah, exactly.
You know,
Earth's still gonna be here. You know what I mean? Now here's the situation that I brought in earlier about there's another myth where scholars say, "Yo, it's just bullshit." The planet Nibiru.
Bullshit.
Okay. Why do you two say bullshit? What is your take on the planet Nibiru?
You know, I've never heard about Nibiru.
Okay.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
It's supposed to be a planet that's inhabited by beings that's supposed to be right outside our solar system. That's supposed to be coming in around 2012.
Right.
To fuck shit up.
Right.
Excuse my language, universe.
We can cuss.
You know, I'm just trying to be direct. I'm not trying to use like any big words. As possible.
It's supposed to be a planet of people.
Yeah, a planet full of, you know, of our original ancestors, and they're supposed to come and
And it's a planet in the sky that we've never seen before.
Never seen before. That's what I'm saying. It's like we would have been seeing it. Anybody would have seen it. That's what I'm saying. They saying the government is trying to cover it up, but the whole thing is we would have been seeing it.
Right.
How would the government cover up the sky?
Yeah. How are you gonna cover up a planet?
Yeah,
but
yeah,
it's supposed to be super, super large.
That is an insult to all astronomers out there. Well, y'all can't see this giant planet coming towards us.
I can't believe you didn't see that rock in the sky.
Yeah,
you know, so that's the whole thing with that. So, I mean, it comes from the this brother named Zachariah Stitchin.
Yeah,
who was I don't know if he was an archaeologist, but he was a scientist that discovered all these tablets.
Mm-hmm.
Where Iraq is, it used to be known as Samaria, and they speak upon Nibiru. But since that time, people have deciphered them tablets, and they found out that Nibiru, that was not it. It was actually Pluto. So,
right. So they misinterpreted everything.
Yeah. Wow. So they just misinterpreted that. So everybody's talking about this. Planet X, this planet, there's no planet X.
Right, right.
My bad, that was just Pluto.
Yeah.
And then now they're saying Pluto isn't even a planet.
Yeah, now they're saying Pluto isn't even a planet.
So,
but that was just a rock from Saturn's rings, my bad.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Whoops.
Exactly.
So, to go feed more into the whole misinterpretation, what if the Mayans, before you got here, I'd asked them, that the Mayans were, I say, you know, okay, let's do a brief history about the Mayans.
Uh-huh.
They were pretty they were pretty advanced. They were not, you know, throwing ooga booga, throwing sticks and shit. Yeah. You know what I mean? They were pretty advanced.
Mm-hmm.
What if this is all wrong? Like, you know, December 22nd, ain't shit happening. No,
I don't think what they're saying is actually wrong. I think how we're interpreting it is wrong. Because there's still followers of the Mayan calendar in that particular region, you know, where the Mayans came up from, and they ain't too bit about any direction.
You know,
any choice where things going on.
Yeah, let's not also forget though that Mayans aren't the only ones on that calendar with that same day ending.
Right.
Exactly. You got the Chinese also.
Chinese.
Right. With the I Ching calendar.
Right. Uh-huh. Yeah.
They got that too. Same day.
Same
in China.
Day. Right.
I believe there's also one other culture. I want to say it is somewhere like Israel or something like that. They got something like Persians or something like that. They got a calendar too.
Okay.
Also,
Egyptians do too.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then Egyptians
as well.
Yeah.
Does anyone know Nostradamus?
Yeah.
The most overrated prophet of all time. Say anything about? I think so. I think so. Come on, man.
I think the whole thing is
that's
this: if you trace life and consciousness and evolution, you're going to come up with some of these predictions.
Right.
But you know. I have to actually give it to, as far as since we're on this topic of prophets and things like that, I have to give it to one of the more modern prophets, and that was Edgar
Casey.
The sleeping prophet.
Mm-hmm. I knew you were there. Yeah.
Yeah. Right. So you know, and he himself had some sort of prediction about 2012. Mm-hmm. I'm not quite sure what it was. I don't think it was too clear to everybody when they heard it.
Let's go ahead and look it up.
But I remember it was not good. I remember it being not positive.
You know, and some Native Americans, they have a prophecy.
Yeah, the Hopi Indians.
But they use this analogy of the fork in the road and our choice to participate in the next shift.
Yeah, I'm more or less going with that one right there. Not just because it's like the safe thing to agree with, but yeah, I think some people are going to be left behind, and some people will,
I think we're about to see a separatism in culture.
Okay.
And we're going to see, I'm just putting it to the basics, you know, because I could explain it scientifically, you know what I'm saying, but I've been smoking, so I ain't been there.
No, wait, we can come back to that. We'll go ahead and get on that, you know what I'm saying? Right now, let me get into this little joint right here. You know, y'all know what time it is.
Yeah.
This is that shit. Group Home.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, Group Home has some tight ass beats. Yo.
Yo. Yeah, this takes me back like 94.
For real.
Yeah. Yo, I think about my, me and yo, my nigga. Kill it like. I know Guru used to write that nigga rhymes though, you know what I'm saying?
Think so?
It sound like Guru's style, like, you know?
I think they was influenced off Guru.
Okay.
Guru, rest in peace, by the way.
Oh yeah, R.I.P. Guru.
Yeah, R.I.P. I have to apologize. I was playing some of the premiere beat while I was playing that DJ Quick. My bad, but you know how that goes.
Let me R.I.P. Dilla, always R.I.P. Dilla. I got you all the time.
Dilla forever. In fact, I'm gonna throw some of his instrumentals in too. You know what I'm saying? So. Yeah.
Uh-huh. R.I.P. Big L.
Yeah.
Big L.
Oh, Big L.
That's right.
You know, while we at it. All right.
Yeah.
I wanted to throw out real quick. We did look up Edward Casey.
Yeah.
And the situation with him, first of all, I encourage any fellow scholars out there to look up Edward Casey. We don't have the time to discuss that man in length right now. But
it's Edgar.
Edgar. Edgar. Oh, I'm sorry. Edgar. Edgar. Thank you. Thank you for that correction.
E-D-G-A-R.
I said
C-A-Y-C-E.
Renaissance man with poor memory. Edgar Casey.
The Ebonics.
but definitely look him up. But basically, he was a prophet, but he couldn't see past the year 2012. He would try during his hypnotic trances to see past that date, but he could not. So he never made a specific prediction about that day, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Sounds bad to me.
Yeah.
And he said something about pole shifts. He said when it comes to Casey and pole shifts, I think he mentioned them so many years ago. When the polar regions were tropical and the oceans were turned about. I don't know.
How do you make 14,000 accurate predictions.
Right.
Look them up.
Period.
Look them up. For real.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't period. Don't sleep on the sleeping prophet.
Yeah, the sleeping prophet.
Sleep on, yeah.
For real.
Look under that Sphinx hand. You're going to find something.
All right.
Yeah. So check it out. Now we'll go into this because I was going to transition over into Atlantis because, you know, he made the prediction about pole shift. He said, you know, the polar regions were tropical.
Yeah.
And so that, you know, okay, we'll get into the whole city of Atlantis.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Scholar, what do you think? Fact, fiction?
Atlantis, I'm open-minded. Mm. I haven't made my own personal conclusion on that, but they're starting to find a lot of compelling evidence that that there was a lot of fact behind the idea of Atlantis. So I'm going to lean towards fact.
Okay. Pure. Fact. Fiction. Fact. Okay.
Six.
Oh, man. I'm really on the fence with this one. Now, as far as Atlantis goes, I mean, there was a civilization. Not sure if it was called Atlantis. There's been a lot of evidence that's been shown that it could have been, you know, a certain Greek civilization.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Not actually Atlantis, but something that was like Atlantis. And then there's also the evidence of you have, you know, I forget, I think it's in the Caribbean somewhere where they found that giant wall that's at the bottom of the ocean right there.
Uh-huh.
Like that, there's that too. I mean, they still don't know anything about that thing.
We want a yes or no, not a lecture. No, I'm just kidding.
Like I said, I can't say I can't say fact or fiction right now because Atlantis could be something else. But you know,
that's what I think. I think the civilization, which they call Atlantis, was called something else.
Could have been, yeah.
You know, because before the last shift, there were, you know, civilizations. The whole thing is, after the shift, there were floods, and there's something like, I think it's like 2,000 cities that they found that's been buried
right
under the earth.
Right. They found pyramids in Japan, I believe.
Yeah. 400-foot pyramids under the water.
Right.
Wait,
in Japan.
Really?
That's what I'm saying. It's like, this stuff is like, it's not even up for argumentation because they've been arguing it for the past 20 years.
There's pyramids in China, too.
Wow.
Yeah, pyramids. Hey, there's a pyramid. They just found another pyramid in London.
What?
They found a, in Turkey, actually, excuse me. Then they found another pyramid. No, they found a whole underground city dated to be at least 10,000 years old in another part of Europe. You got rain erosion on the Sphinx.
Hmm. Wow.
You got, like you said, you got pyramids everywhere. You got a pyramid in Georgia. They found a pyramid in Georgia. They found artifacts, Egyptian artifacts, in the Grand Canyon.
Wow.
All this shit is documented. It's like, it's straight fact.
They found what in the Grand Canyon?
They found Egyptian artifacts in the Grand Canyon.
But would that make it Egyptian if it's in the Grand Canyon?
Huh?
Would that make it Egyptian if it's in the Grand Canyon?
He's saying they found Meduneter. They found scribe. They found...
No, yeah. I don't understand what you mean.
Like if they found it buried in the Grand Canyon, would that really make it Egyptian? Because Egyptian would just be pertaining to Egypt.
It's an Arizonian.
If that was like...
No, he's saying,
artifacts.
The same
artifacts you would find in Egypt, you find the same artifacts in the Grand Canyon.
Yeah.
They're not supposed to...
But maybe
never supposed to meet like that.
Maybe it was a different civilization that maybe had the same type of culture as Egyptians, but over here.
Not actually, because it dates back to they said Seti. Is that his name, Seti? I can't say his name, but they pinned it to a certain pharaoh.
Oh, okay.
They pinned it to a certain pharaoh. So.
Oh, got you. During his era.
Yeah, during his era. So.
Okay, so they must have traveled over here or something.
They didn't travel somewhat.
A lot of people go to see the Grand Canyon.
Yeah.
It's a national monument.
Yeah.
Kind of boring.
You ever heard of that? A book called American BC?
No, I've not.
Check that book out, American BC by Barry Fail. And they came before Columbus.
Yeah, I heard about that one.
You ever heard of a book called Nature Knows No Color Lines?
Sounds okay.
Yeah, check that shit out.
Sounds good.
Okay.
Nature knows no color lines.
Yeah,
we're gonna have to start up a book club, like how Oprah has, you know, the book club. You know?
For real, yeah, we should.
No, for real, honestly, because it's like I recommend if you want to be a rapper or MC or get into the entertainment industry, go pick up that book, The Truth About the FBI War Against Tupac Shakur. It's real deep. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And then, you know, other books, like I'm going to transition over into another topic. Aliens, what do you call, well, I don't know what you want to call them, fallen angels, Nephilim, things of that nature. Let's go ahead and talk about that. I mean, you know, it's kind of in correlation with 2012, in a sense, because, you know, like I said, the planet Nibiru, but, you know, no one believes that. Wait, what was your take on Nibiru? You said it was bullshit.
Yeah,
right?
I think it's bullshit.
Right, okay.
Yeah. But I think I still believe in the ancient alien theory.
Oh, yeah, definitely. See, that's what I was going to transition over to, just to kind of talk about that. Mm-hmm. Ancient aliens.
Yeah, that's it.
What's up? Any relation to the whole 2012 situation with, you know, because if y'all had strong beliefs in Nibiru, we could have went more into depth of like, okay, did Anunnaki and all things of that nature. I mean, you know, maybe we get a little too deep.
Just get a telescope and look in the sky.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, that itself will tell you right there.
Find a strong telescope and look in the sky, and that tell you right there.
I mean, really, we could just go to Griffith Observatory right now, man. You know what I'm saying?
And, yeah.
See we could cracking, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Hey, wait, Nibiru, where you at?
Right. Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah.
But, no, really, though, aliens in 2012, I mean, you can say that a lot of the things that were derived from all those ancient cultures, or ancient civilizations, you know, they got a lot of that knowledge maybe from the aliens.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it goes in really deep when you bring it to that level. I mean, there's not enough evidence for anybody to really stand upon to say that aliens have some sort of specific influence in 2012, you know?
Yeah. I would recommend any scholars out there to do your own personal research on ancient civilizations in relation to aliens and make your own conclusion. Some of this may sound a little bit far-fetched to many of you, but I would suggest just do your own research and see what you find.
Yeah, it's like, I know this, it might seem far-fetched to a lot of you guys, but if you look at the research, I don't even give a damn.
Mm-hmm.
Because is that real?
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's hard to say things like this because people think you crazy. But once you, that's what I'm saying. Anybody refutes anything that we're talking about, I mean, we can be off on some issues. But if you really do the research, you will find things that you just can't believe. So if you know what I'm saying, that's where I'm at now. I don't even care.
Oh yeah. I know that way.
Yeah, it's like it's real. It's things out there that we can't explain.
Yeah, I mean,
we can't explain it. The people just don't want to explain it.
That's right, kids. History is not boring.
Exactly.
Yeah, you know, I mean, we go in with the whole building of pyramids, like how did the pyramids get constructed? I mean, and then why were they constructed? See, it's like, you know, you can go in like that, and
that's a whole nother topic.
I think pyramids in itself, you know, even though you have pyramids all over the world, I think certain pyramids were built for certain things,
right? Yeah, the
and it's so simple that you couldn't believe it.
The three pyramids in Egypt, you know, they kind of correlate to the Orion's Belt. Right? Am I right? The three stars in the sky.
That so actually, there's a lot. The main configurations of pyramids, the main civilizations, Maya, Egyptian, they all had that same pyramid configuration with the three.
Right.
Same formation.
Right. Now, you know what I'm saying? So you think about that, something.
Yeah, and the Egyptian pyramids, and they subscribed these pharaohs to be the builder of these pyramids. They did not build them pyramids. Those pyramids was refurbished.
Right.
Over long periods of time.
Pyramids. So.
Well, you think about it, though, but they never found nothing about no pharaohs. Ain't no mummies in the pyramids. Ain't nothing.
Because the whole thing is this. It's a machine. It's not a tomb.
Yeah.
Built like a machine.
It's actually built like a machine.
Actually more like factory.
Yeah.
Factory. It makes more sense.
It creates things. It makes energy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What did the Egyptians say about 2012? Anyone here know?
What did the Egyptians say about 2012? Who
they
has
say
knowledge of that?
Basically the same thing that the Mayans say. Now, I believe it to be a point of a higher consciousness and a different evolution.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
period.
Yeah.
I don't believe it that it's going to be the end of the world. I believe that it could be some destruction and stuff going on, but the end of the world, I really don't.
The end of,
really
the end of someone's world, the end of some people's world.
Yeah, the end of some bullshit.
Somebody, yeah, yeah. I mean, we see it. It's kind of all correlating with, I see, like, the whole movements that are going on right now that has never been really done before. The 99%.
Nothing like it.
The Occupy movement. You know, it's gonna be, someone's shit's gonna end.
Yeah,
I mean, you know what I'm saying? Not,
I mean, you got two political boogeymen that just went down just this year.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? I mean, it's a big thing.
Well, who you talking about? Who you talking about? Herman Cain?
He no, we got
Cain buy no pussy.
No,
he can't even buy.
We talking about Osama and Kim Jong.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Gaddafi.
Yeah, yeah,
Gaddafi.
All the stuff was going down.
Don't sleep on Gaddafi. He's too pretty to sleep on.
Man, the way that went down. Oh, that video. I saw. Did you guys see that?
That was cold. How they did him, bro. Oh,
man. Why did they put that on TV?
But that show, that's karma like a motherfucker.
Oh, yeah.
That make you think. Don't be a dictator.
You're right.
You never know when the people go back.
But check it out.
Hey,
Gaddafi. I don't want to be a dictator no more.
Gaddafi, yo, he put it down for Libya, though, because, I mean, you know, he dug deep into the ground, got water for his people. I mean, he's done some amazing things. But, yeah, overall, yeah, don't be a dictator. I mean,
he didn't do shit for them people.
No, no. Well, supposedly he did. I mean, think about it, man. They were importing a lot of water from you know, neighboring countries, and you know they dug the aquifer. He constructed the aquifer. He was also on some other shit about like get on the gold standard.
Uh-huh.
You know, like he was really trying to like create Northern Africa, really all of Africa, into a real economic powerhouse.
Well, see, I think that's what was
that kind of
a problem. Something going on with him personally, you know.
You think so?
Yeah, that's why somebody stuck him right.
Oh,
he
man.
Fucking up. He was doing something fucked up.
Yeah,
he was doing something fucked up.
It was the hair.
I mean, he should. Yeah,
you see them military outfits you said? I was like, damn, this nigga look like a rapper. Like,
yeah, he looked like Trey D when Trey D did his album back in 03. Like that, like the general, like Gaddafi.
He had DJ Quick's perm.
Yeah, he had a little perm.
He didn't have Quick's perm. He had Eazy-E's perm, homie.
Oh, hey, was he on that Noriega album?
Yo, I think he's on it.
In the Philippines. With a mansion.
Real.
Yo, yeah, Gaddafi. Yeah, I mean, you know, something, I mean, you know, I wouldn't say bad guy, but he definitely should have just been, you know, step the fuck down. You know, it's a whole new movement going, and, you know, he could have helped this country prosper. But, he decided to do some bullshit. Yo, we're going to check this out, man. We're going to go into some beautiful hardcore. I don't know if you're aware of this guy right here, man. His name is Ahmad Jamal. Just a week ago, you was free from the stress. Why the hell do you jump ahead of me? We wasn't ready for no Nas just yet. Right. Yeah. Okay, we're back. We back like the hair on your mama back. We back like those turkey toenails. No, that was never back. We're back like skinny jeans from the 70s. Nah, let me see. I'm trying to just come up with something clever.
Please don't compare me to skinny jeans.
We're back like
skinny jeans. Why do niggas wear skinny jeans and sag them and you can see they whole ass?
That's nasty.
I don't understand that.
Yeah, I don't get it either, son.
That's a whole lot of wrong right there.
Yeah. You gonna wear tight ass jeans, nigga. At least be aerodynamic with them motherfuckers. Be like a superhero or something. Be able to hop a fence, nigga.
Right.
They can hop a fence with tight ass jeans on, nigga, sagging the jeans.
Nah.
You see your whole ass, you can't even hop the nigga.
The whole thing is
cure is done. He's like, you know what?
He just walked out the business. Man,
he just like left. Now, yo, we'll talk about these movements though. Like, I think I'm gonna have to get with y'all. We're gonna definitely have to like schedule in some more situations like this throughout the year.
Uh-huh.
Because you know, we can touch up on a whole lot of topics. Just the whole 2012 situation is just kind of like the tip of the iceberg. Like I said, right now, I think it's gonna be a big movement with just movements. Like I said, the whole 99 percenters, the Occupy movement.
Yep.
I think we need a movement in hip hop because
Occupy hip hop.
We need to occupy. We need to. I mean, man, this
wage
dude,
war.
Man, Marie Antoinette, how did they cut? You know, let them eat cake. Like, why are these rappers talking about shit that the average cat can't really relate to? I mean, real talk. I mean,
like hip hop for me. Hip hop for me has always been about the imagination. If you go back to Africa Bambaataa and Kool Herc, even to the Sugar Hill Gang, you know, hip hop was made to make ourselves bigger than who we are.
Right.
So we can escape this fucking this mental slave state.
Right.
So it's like when a nigga say, I got, you know, a big ass TV and cars, you know, that's really part of hip hop, to push your imagination, to push you to another level, you know what I'm saying, of things you didn't have, you know.
Yeah, but
you know,
but
I put it like this, the whole thing now is like, okay, why is motherfuckers talking about having all this money and having all this shit, and we in the biggest financial crisis we've ever been in since the Depression? It's like, it don't make
logical sense. That's what I'm saying. Like,
don't
it's
make
like,
any sense.
I mean, yeah, hip hop is about imagination, but really, I'm what I'm really saying. I mean, you know, if we get down to the root cause or the root, why hip hop is here. It's hip. What KRS-One say? Hip is to know. Mm-hmm. It's a form of intelligence. To be hip is to be update and relevant. Hop is a form of movement. Mm-hmm. You can't just observe a hop. You got to hop up and do it.
Yeah.
So why are we not talking about pertinent things? Like, you know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, I got a, you know, shout out to my nephew Dighead. He's out there getting his little getting awareness out, talking about war, things, you know, capitalism. But like, I don't hear Ludacris. No, you know, no disrespect to Ludacris. I don't hear Ludacris. I don't hear nobody like a mainstream artist talking about anything political. That's kind of why I mean, you know, it's, yeah, like I said, imagination, yes. You know what I'm saying? I'm on some imaginary shit, too. You know, I just played my joint Miles to Earth.
Yeah.
I'm talking about, you know. But you know what I'm saying? Like, no political, nobody talking about nothing. Mm-hmm. Like, really? That's why I said we'll sit down and talk. Because honestly, I voted for Obama. But, not another 4 years. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But sure as hell won't give it to a Republican. But we have the power to change that. Yeah, Ron Paul. I'm with Ron Paul.
Ron Paul.
All day. All day, every day. That, yeah, he sounds like it. Yeah, yeah. But other than that, but I'm saying though, like, what if Game or somebody actually spoke up on something like that? Or Jay-Z even said, you know what, Obama, blah, 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 I suggest y'all vote for, I mean, you know, your vote is your vote, but I'm just saying, you know, let's get back into the whole issues talking about,
you
know.
These are part of the people that put Obama in office.
Right, I know.
Remember when he was running for presidency? I was in Atlanta.
Uh-huh.
And it's just like you heard all these Obama songs.
Yeah.
You're just hearing all these Obama songs.
Right.
So, I mean, nope. I don't think people want to admit that they made a mistake. And I feel a lot of people think that they made a mistake.
Yeah, I feel...
Hey, let's not forget...
Politicians that talk change, but it's more like the same.
Let's not forget that if Obama lost, our president would be John McCain. And are we sure that that's that would have been a better decision?
Hey, but think about the Occupy movement under John McCain. Think about that.
Oh boy!
Wow, you think they?
Shit.
Yo, but I'm just saying. Yeah, you know, look, they put him in office to, because they knew a revolution was coming. So they said, okay, let's get this cat up in here, so these cats would be quiet. You know what I'm saying?
I'm saying.
You know what I mean? That's what I'm saying.
It kind of, especially, I feel it's that way, like in the minority community, because
right.
We were so close.
Right.
So close to just to going off the deep end and saying, fuck this shit.
Right.
Going crazy.
Right.
And then they brought Obama in, and then it was like,
okay, calm down.
Okay, at least we got a black president.
Yeah. Okay. Just a glitch. Oh, we're good.
I think the government, I think Obama's tapping into our feed right now.
Yo,
it's getting a little too
kiss my real black ass.
It's getting bacon too
black
hot.
Ass. Yeah, that's what it is. That's what it was. Maybe it was them. Who gives a fuck? That's why I say we're gonna go further than just this one of these days. We'll be the first hip hop cats to do our thing and really take control of some situations, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, because I feel it's like this, especially with hip-hop and a lot of stuff in general. It's like these facts are just still underground. I don't want them to be underground no more.
Right, right.
Fuck
yeah.
That shit.
Yeah, let's put it out there. That's what I'm saying. That's exactly what I'm talking about. You know what I mean? Put it out there. Kind of, you know. But anyway, we've been on our soapbox. Basically, bro, y'all two. Scholar, Six.
Uh-huh. Yep. Yep.
Here's the situation. You know, I like saying situation because of this song, Situations. Are y'all up on Del the Funky Homo Sapien? Y'all don't know about
that? I remember that.
Okay, this is Situations. Just situations that we go through. Yo, the situation at hand is 2012. Do you see, like I was saying about a revolution? Like we were talking about off when we were, you know, before we were talking about just the revolution period. I mean, it's 2012, the time. Do you think you're going to see more of that? More revolution, just the revolutionary thinking, revolutionary actions, and, you know, definitely revolutionary.
Yeah.
Like, yo, Scholar, you're a vegetarian.
Yes, I am.
Like
a vegetarian
also. That's a revolutionary act in itself right there. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I can't help but be optimistic, and I see a lot of encouraging signs that human civilization as a whole is improving. I think we have a long ways to go,
mm-hmm.
but I feel that the overall consciousness is beginning to become slightly overall more aware,
mm-hmm.
and I think there's positive signs about 2012 being not just, you know, we've been talking a lot about like the world blowing up and yada yada yada, but there's also many encouraging signs that 2012, if anything, is going to bring about a positive change. And I think people are beginning to think differently than they did in the past. You think about the notion of, like, when we were kids, you know, 10, 15 years ago, whatever and whatnot, the idea of aliens, it was like, oh, 1 out of 10 people believed in it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the one person who believed in it was crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Now you ask around and, you know, it's pretty widely accepted that the idea that a universe is so large, not containing life on other planets, is, you know, fairly absurd.
Right.
So people are definitely beginning to change the way they think. So I think people are beginning to make changes, and that will change culture.
Yeah.
And we could see the next phase in human culture, and people will start to think differently and whatnot. And if worse comes to worse, at least my album, The Revolution, will be dropping in 2012. So there will be at least one revolution happening.
Right. Most definitely. Six.
Now, this goes back to being, you know, the other ways that 2012 could occur, and this is like the spiritual side, or the you know, the psychological side to it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, as with what Scholar was saying, people are willing to accept a lot more things nowadays. Basically, what I had a discussion the other night with a friend, and they were telling me that their personal take on 2012 was that it was going to be some kind of life-changing awakening. People would be stressed out by the thought of an end of the world actually coming to you know, coming to terms. And what, you know, maybe not everybody who thinks this way, but this individual seems to think that 2012 is something that get him in gear and to change his life, to just go ahead and pick up his bucket list and start doing things. And that,
right,
in turn is going to cause him to believe that once 2012 comes around, nothing goes down. He's like, wow, I just kind of lived my life that little bit more, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Just that little bit more. And it's going to cause a lot of people to kind of follow trend and then just kind of start being more
fulfilling their potential.
Yeah, fulfilling human potential, basically.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it also comes to say, like, he also saying that a brighter side is that the Mayan calendar, you know, the fact that it ended is, you know, maybe it's not just coincidence. I mean, the Mayans were invaded by the Spaniards, and that civilization was taken apart and turned, you know, they came and cultured the whole place, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And so maybe that they only got so far on the calendar, and when the Spaniards took over, they couldn't continue, and their culture changed, and that was a huge, you know, just change there that they just left behind.
No doubt.
That is a very optimistic way to look at things, you know.
Yeah, I mean, I'm choosing more the optimistic viewpoint myself because, I mean, the other point is we're just all going to die. So I'd rather choose the more positive one.
Yeah.
So it's like I've been doing research on the whole thing, and this shaman, I forgot his name, but he's been up in the mountains dealing with these other shaman, and he's just talking about how that the Mayan calendar actually is ending because what we perceive as time is ending. And we're going to have a lot of open choices in 2012, beyond 2012, on the way we perceive creation and how things are being created. And things are going to be being created a lot faster, and it's going to be more of it. Like, you, now we have this thing, nanotechnology, right? With these small nanomolecular robots coming in and going in your body and curing cancer and things like that. And they say where we'll be in 10 years, you know, we won't even recognize ourselves. So I think that's one thing that it is. That's the positive thing that's coming out of it.
Also, with the, not to cut you off, but wanted to add into this, but like the Hadron Collider, they're pretty close to isolating the God particle, which is a humongous, humongous physics breakthrough likes that we've never seen in our lifetime.
It's also known as the scientific unit is the Higgs boson.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Or,
and also, we're also finding tons of planets out there. I think Kepler's set to release 2012 the next batch of planets they've found, and they're very optimistic about all these planets in the Goldilocks zone that are supposed to be, you know, very much like Earth. So who knows, maybe 2012 is also the time where we finally are able to have a greater understanding of the universe and what's really out there.
Yeah, it's like crazy, science fiction is becoming science fact. I was just watching this thing on clones, and no, first of all, let me break it down. I was watching a movie, and the dude was in a lab, and he was creating glow-in-the-dark hamsters. And then
I don't like where this is going.
No. And then I'm watching a thing on cloning. Now they have glow-in-the-dark dogs and cats. So I'm going to leave y'all my email if anybody want to, you know, see that, you know, because it blows people's mind.
What's your email?
MeUSame@gmail.
Wait a minute.
MeUSame@gmail.
@gmail.
Okay. Now why?
Are they testing on animals? That's inhumane.
Yeah, well, hey.
Well.
You got to do something on somebody.
You know, I just found out what I wanted for Christmas. I want a glow-in-the-dark dog.
So we have glow-in-the-dark dogs, glow-in-the-dark puppies.
Yeah. That glow-in-the-dark puppies for everybody, man.
Yeah.
That's
we
the way have. To do it.
It's a violation of animal rights.
Well, you want to talk to Richard Gere about some violation of hamsters.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
I don't want to know what he's going to do with the glow-in-the-dark hamster.
Let's not right, even man. Guess. All right, hold tight, y'all. Hold tight.
That science fiction becoming science fact, y'all.
I'm having a little, we have to do a little station identification. Hold tight, y'all. We'll be back. Yeah. All right. Don't say that damn latency. Come back. Most
to
deaf.
Be free, to be free.
Most deaf.
I want my all my people to be free.
So I put on something. I scared the
give F. us free.
I scared the F out of somebody. I was like, yeah, rest in peace, Most Deaf. I'm like, rest in peace, Most Deaf. I'm like, yeah, because, you know, he changing his name to Yasin in 2012. They're like, oh, why'd you scare me like that? I was like, shut up. You know, taking stuff all literal. Yeah, but he's changing his name to Yasin. That's dope. Like, I forgot what it means, but I was like, okay, that's what's up. I got to read that. I forgot. You know what I mean? Yasin. You know what I'm talking about?
Most Deaf.
Most definitely.
Word.
I remember Most Deaf. I first heard Most Deaf on De La Soul Stakes Is High album. I was like, yo, this guy's nice.
Mm-hmm.
This guy's dying.
Shout out De La Soul.
De La Soul.
Yeah, man, I ain't seen him perform in a while, man. Yeah, maybe like 2-3 years.
Yeah. I was in my lawn.
At the Queen Mary. They was at the Queen Mary.
You know the stakes.
Yeah, speaking of De La, I'm going to go into some of that.
That was one of my favorite groups, yo.
Yeah, still is one of my favorites. Yeah. Next to the Far Side.
Far Side. Woo.
Oh, you know, Owu. What you say?
Next to Rough Riders.
Nate,
Rough, wow.
Nuke Ingrich.
Rough Riders.
Rough Riders. All right, so look, we're pretty much at the end of this broadcast. You know, this is the first for Wolf Tickets, and you know, we're gonna have plenty more. You know, just stay tuned. You know what I mean? I say follow me at AO2K, and you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna just go ahead and just we'll end with let's just end on the positive, like we said. Let's focus on the positive. What's the positive outcome of 2012? I mean, we talked about all this death and destruction and possibility of aliens coming back to eat us. yo, what's positive? What's going to happen in 2012? Go ahead, Scholar.
Well, regardless of the outcome of 2012, I think every human being should, like Six was saying earlier, live to their full potential. Why wait for tomorrow to try to achieve the things that you want to achieve now? Improve yourself, improve your life, make the quality of life for those around you better.
Mm-hmm.
And no matter what happens for 2012, and I personally, if you were to ask me, I don't know what's going to happen, but I believe that there will be slow, progressive human culture change, but I don't foresee a giant pole shift. Of course, if I'm wrong, we're all dead, but so it don't matter.
Not unless I'm in the Drakensberg Mountain.
Unless I'm in the Drakensberg Mountain.
I'll be right there.
But maybe this time next year we will be broadcasting from South Africa.
Yeah. Told y'all stuck up, man.
South Africa, musty as hell. I ain't going to the damn South Africa, nigga. I'd rather drown. I'm just fucking with you. Catch me in South Africa.
We won't be there.
That's where we will be.
Yeah. Hey, just to let you know, South Africa is the rape capital of the world.
Yeah.
Hey,
that's what I'm saying. Everybody like
that. And it's also now it is going to be the safest place in the world if 2012 comes with that whole pole shift.
Yeah, then the motherfuckers like raping, and then my neighbors enjoy that shit.
You won't rape me.
But
yeah,
you know,
they ain't rape nothing.
But back on track, right?
South, by the way.
Yeah, you know, I've heard that fact, and that was from
I don't know, South Africa.
From somebody, and
I don't know, man. You can't be making, ask Dana White, you can't be making jokes like that.
Yeah.
It ain't me, son.
You got the Illuminati hookup.
It ain't me, son.
That's spooky. Yo. But, really, though, I mean, you know, just taking it back, you know, everyone's just needs, sorry, I was a little distracted there. Everyone just needs I think everyone's going to come to a realization that, you know, everyone's just becoming more spiritually aware and how things are being done, and being more aware of themselves. And I think that's what's going to lead, you know, just basically what's going to lead into a new era of thought and, and such, you know.
Okay.
I think it's going to be the end of the philosophy of the spirit and the beginning of the technology of the spirit.
Ooh, deep.
Yeah.
I would say the Clippers will win the NBA championship. That's how you know some shit's going down.
Yeah, you smoking.
Only it's going down.
Only said that shit last year. Motherfuckers have been like, this nigga smoking that. But yeah, it's a possibility. That's a possibility. But yeah, nonetheless, though, I'm going to, honestly, same thing. I say it's a spiritual shift in consciousness. And, you know, let's keep it pushing. I think next time, though, I'll talk about the singularity. I don't know if a lot of cats are up on that.
Which one?
The singularity, to where when computers will be faster.
Oh,
or
yeah.
When computers will be self-aware.
Yeah, because there's two singularities, because he got that from a scientific term.
Yeah.
And then he made his own term.
Right, right.
You know what I'm
saying?
Right. Yeah.
Right. But that's the computer singularity right there.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we'll touch up on that next time or whatever. Maybe that's what we'll do. We'll touch up on that. But, you know, speaking of rock cocaine flow, I have to go get some of that rock cocaine. You know, I'm a bass head, big beat bass head. You know what I mean?
Like, 808.
Next time we're going to freestyle in this motherfucker. You know what I mean?
What's going to be cool?
Yeah, I think it says we got like three listeners. I appreciate that.
Trey listeners, we got three listeners. I'm celebrating everything. 2012 celebrating. We got three listeners.
That's what's up.
That's three more than we had before.
But check this out. I didn't even blow this up though. Like I just kind of put it out there.
Hey, that's three smarter people.
We gotta shout out the three people by name now.
Yeah, so, if you are three listening, go ahead and tweet me right now. AO2K, you can tweet my man Pure Etc. at Pure ETC. And Skylar, he doesn't do Twitter.
I don't know what that is. I don't like the phone either, so if you see me, then say hi.
Yeah, just go ahead and say hi to Skylar. And we up out of here, though, you know what I'm saying? So, you know.
Yo. Can I put my thing in?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yo, I got a show January 13th, Nokia Theater.
Oh, yeah.
Busta Rhymes, Rick Ross.
Yeah.
Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I'm spinning that unbelievable. So don't, you know what I'm saying? You hear the names, don't think you think what it is because you do not know what it is.
You do not know. You're not aware.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Kind of check that shit out.
Go ahead. Anything else you got to plug in, Six?
For the moment, not right now, but just keep an eye out on Scholar. You're going to see something coming up.
Yeah. My website's up, but there's nothing on there, but scholarshere.com will be the future. I got my video. We're filming it right now.
Yeah.
So it's coming out. You know, all three of y'all can come check that out one day.
Yeah.
But in the meantime, keep coming back here. We dropping some knowledge out here, okay? Knowledge is power.
Yep.
We're all scholars, okay?
Yeah. Yo, let me give you my website.
Go ahead.
PureEtcMusic.com.
Yeah.
You can follow me at PureEtc on Twitter.
Yeah.
PureEtc.
Yeah, yeah.
Music.com.
I'm going to give a shout out. Pure, he's the truth. Scholar. Mm-hmm. He's bringing that revolution. Yeah, the cat got fire. Y'all gotta, you know, this is hip hop. You know, this that Occupy hip hop. You know what I mean? So I encourage all these other rappers to go on strike or just quit. Cause you know, I think this is the year of the real MC.
Mm-hmm. Sir,
you know. No, this is the millennium of the real MC.
The long calendar, the long count calendar of the real MC. So
the physics of a real MC.
There it is. All right, we're gonna be up out of here. We up out of here.